good food is just not enough. It needs to be more.
No. No. Big bordel. Too messy. Come, come, carry on, carry on.
It needs to be a personal approach.
Tac.
You need to make people feel like they are home and really treat everyone individually, differently, in order for people to remember and transform moments into memories. Hi, I'm Julien Royer, chef owner of Odette Restaurant. Let me show you around. So the style of food here, it's a French cuisine, because this is what I learned and this is what the way I was trained. But it's a cuisine that has evolved because I'm here in Asia for nearly 10 years. And we always try to incorporate a little excitement, a little bit of Asian twist. I really want people to feel a lot of love in what we cook, because this is the story of Odette. This is the story of the restaurant. This is my story. The restaurant is named after my grandmother Odette, because she's the person who showed me how much pleasure, how much joy, how much happiness and emotion you can give to people through food and cuisine. Singapore is a bit of a paradox because there is not much space for growing stuff here in Singapore, and you quickly realize that Singapore is a very well organized country where you can bring anything from anywhere. And you know, it just makes the cooking better.
Let me tell you a bit about the design of the restaurants. Our capacity is around 30 to 35 people. The restaurant is located within the National Art Gallery premises. It's a very old building, probably one of the oldest buildings in Singapore. And we were lucky enough to have the space here, and we opened our door in October 2015.
The art gallery is beautiful and it's definitely a source of open-mindedness. And I think, you know, as a chef, it's important to look at any kind of and any form of art.
We also create a line of little packages and stuff for the restaurants. For instance, here we have this beautiful box that is also a jam. And this is something that we give to the guests when they are leaving the restaurants. So they have a little memories of us the day after. It's a recipe from my grandma, and I wanted to share it with the guests. So during the service, I will stand where this young man is right now. Here is the pass, is where all the food will be sent to the dining room. And what's important for us is the tempo. It needs to be, you know, the tempo is really important. And come in, and from here, I can see how people eat slow, fast, and the tempo is really easier to manage that way. Hello! So what are you working on, chef? Form is okay, sorbet is good.
The color looks different, no? I think, you know, us as a chef, we have a role to play in the well-being of, you know, our chefs and our people in the kitchen. And it's time for us, the new generation of young chefs, to give people a proper place to work with a proper work ethic.
We start with a crab dish. So crab with apple, wasabi, and coriander. A sorbet made of apple and celery and ginger. I'm gonna put this very thin layer of jelly.
So the jelly will cover everything.
I'm gonna put a few dots of this avocado puree.
It's like the comfort zone of the dish. Some finger lime. Bit of cheese. Give me mint and coriander.
The dashi.
So this is a signature dish because it represents very well the style of cooking we are doing. It's a French cuisine, but again, we try to bring a very interesting and different Asian twist into it. This is the pepper that we use for the crust of the pigeon. It comes from Cambodia. It's called kampot pepper. Black garlic puree. Then the leg of the pigeon that has been confit. We put it on the side here. We designed this plate especially for that dish. Little message for the guest to know more about the dish. It goes here into the leg. The pigeon breast.
I truly think that as a chef, as a cook, we can taste, learn, smell, and see new things every day. And for that reason, I think we are more artisan than artists. I really believe that you can do better every day, and you can refine the cooking and the dining experience every day.